Now, the next thing I want to do is I want to show you a very aggressive cut. And this is if you were in your shop and you needed to just cut a piece of 8/4 material and you wanted to just do it really quickly. So this is a piece of 8/4 sepo. This is a full 1 3/4 inches thick. And I'm going to drop this end off of this cracked board. You know, I don't mind because this is a waste piece. And but I'm going to try to cut it fast, but I'm going to try to cut it pretty square and accurate too. So to show that it can be done even with a rough carpentry type saw as this. So I've got a line drawn on here. And again, you know, your classic Western woodworker would try to cut this like this. This way. Holding your elbow up. That's not the way we're going to do it. We're going to drop that handle and we're going to cut it like this. Got a little bit of drift that way, but I'm pretty square there. That's not too bad, but that shows you how quickly you can just make, I mean, this is sepo, this is mahogany, so I mean you can imagine what it'd do to a piece of white wood. You know, it'll just go through it like it's styrofoam. So the final thing that I want to do is show you how easy it is to take these blades out of these handles and replace them. And also keep old blades on hand, so if I've got to cut something that say has epoxy or glue and I don't want to make a mess on my blade, I'll just pop an old one in. That's it. That's all you got to do. Just put it right back in. This one is the most complicated one to change because it actually requires a tool to change the blade, namely a screwdriver. And but you'll see how easy these other two don't require any tools at all because they have this this threaded piece here. Okay, so this doesn't even need to come all the way out, that the threaded knob. So you just pop this out, just pull it out. And you can see this notch that's cut in here. That's where the threaded piece locks it down into that notch. And then the blade is simply sandwiched into this steel receiver. And so to put it back together again, you just put it in, slide it down until the notch lines up with the notch in the receiver. This just comes in here, put it down. There, that one's, and now for this one's just exactly the same. It's just that the receiver that holds the blade, the stiffener, is a lot longer. So the same notch, this just slips down inside that receiver. The notch lines up, and then it just goes right back into the handle again. So these are great tools. This one I know is 25 years old. This one's probably 23 years old, and this one's probably about 10 or 11, the handles. So these are a great addition to any woodworking shop. And if you had to choose just two of them, these would be the two here. So if you could only afford to buy two of them, these would be the two to get. And if you could only afford to buy one, this would be the one to get. This is the most versatile, that has the cross cut and the rip on the same blade. It is very aggressive, so it is not for fine furniture work. Not like these two are for finer work. But this one is just for, this is just for getting it on. That's what this one is for. I mean, this is when you just need to get it on and you need to make a cut. And by the time you did something like get a jigsaw or a skill saw out, you're done and you're moved on to the next operation. So this thing is just for getting busy. Okay, and I'll show you where I keep mine so they're always handy. This is a tool caddy, a mobile tool caddy that I have in my shop that I can wheel around. It's got all the stuff that I'm generally using. And these saws just live here. So they're very accessible, yet they're also up and out of the way, so they're not going to get damaged or bent. So if I need to use one of these, there it is. It's that easy. And if I want to do it with a flourish, let me try the flourish again on this one. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoy using Japanese saws as much as I do.